is trying really hard to be competitive in one of the toughest market segments. So we grabbed this new CTS coupe and put it against its closest competitors, the BMW 335 IS and the Audi S5.
This is the new BMW coupe, the 335 IS. The 3 Series has an unbelievably wide range of cars available. You can get into one for the low 30s. This car costs almost $60,000. That is an enormous range for one model. The problem I have is that lots of the 3 Series don't feel like the ultimate driving machine. I wish for more power, and I wish for a little bit harder suspension tuning, especially when you get into the 328s. They just don't have that.
If you're buying a BMW 3 Series, I ask you, why? Are we buying a fantastic car, or are we buying this badge? What is the point of buying a 3 Series unless it's something special?
This is the hottest 3 Series you can buy that is not the M3. What BMW has done is offered you a factory tuner car version of the 3 Series. It's got a little bit lower stance, it's got some bits in it from the M car. It's just generally tuned to be more than just a BMW cruiser.
It's such an interesting little beast, but it's $57,000. That's a problem. I think BMW has gone off the deep end with their prices, and I feel like I'm overpaying in the BMW. It's nice, it's fine, but people aren't gonna get in and go, ooh, nice car.
BMW has been passed by many other automakers in the style of their interiors. I mean, the gauges are clear and the steering wheel's nice. Those are big scores. But beyond that, it just starts to feel kind of staid and boring. When you compare that to the Cadillac, which has got nothing but style, and the Audi, which is the most refined interiors on the planet, this really had a lot of catching up to do. And at this price point, this interior should be more impressive.
The interior is fine, but okay, whatever. And an extra scoop of whatever.
Now the materials are nice. Everything is nice, soft touch leathers and plastics, and the seats are great.
BMW and Volvo make the best seats in the business, and BMW has not let me down.
You could actually take a road trip in this car and the people in the back wouldn't hate you. Your seating position is very forward and upright, no matter what you do with the seat, and the visibility is really fantastic.
The single biggest place the BMW lets me down is the styling. It just doesn't stand out. The only things that differentiate this car are the blacked out mirrors, the black tailpipes, and the grille, so most people aren't going to notice. It just looks like everybody else who owns a BMW 3 Series, and that's pretty much everybody.
Of the current 3 Series, I've always felt like the coupe had the cleanest styling. I love the sleek lines of the hood that doesn't have the bulbous center of the M3.
It just doesn't stand out. In a parking lot, on the street, it just looks like another BMW.
It just looks smaller and less interesting than both of the other two cars.
But because it doesn't stand out from the crowd, that means you're buying it for a different reason than the rest of the crowd.
This IS feels very fast, and the main reason is because this has more torque than the M3. Think about that for a minute. This twin-turbo six-cylinder has more sheer twist and grunt under your ass than the V8 M3. And it'll give you that torque right about 2,000 RPMs. So almost directly off the line, you feel an amazing amount of surge coming out of this car.
Wow, this car has endless power. Wait till you drive this thing. The inline sixes from BMW are perfectly balanced. You can rev them to the moon, and this car is no exception.
Because it's a turbo engine, BMW has programmed it to allow for a little bit of overboost. For up to about 10 seconds, you can get 370 foot-pounds of torque. That's enough to pull tree stumps out of the ground.
Yes, please, another scoop of that. It's like a horse that just got jabbed with a cattle prod.
When you floor it, it doesn't feel like this car settles back on its rear suspension. It almost feels like it leans forward and attacks the road. And all this torque connected with summer tires makes this wet driving a little nuts.
I gotta slow down, it's freaking raining.
You just can't ever complain about BMW brakes. They're always fantastic.
I'm amazed. This is going to be a really tough comparison.
BMW does a good job in most of their cars of giving you a heavy involved steering feel. I have to say, it's great to be in a car where the steering isn't overboosted.
So for all their fantastic handling, they've just made it better somehow. It's wired to my brain. I cannot believe that. It feels so sharp and dynamic, but it doesn't beat you up.
There's a lot of power and aggression here, but it's muted a bit. It's kind of softened for luxury use, kind of like getting hit in the face with a velvet hammer. There's no question that the IS has a sharper, harder ride than the rest of the 3 Series line. But I actually feel like that starts to make it live up to its name of being the ultimate driving machine.
The 335 IS is like a Zen garden. Everything's in harmony.
Now, the paddle shift transmission in this car is faster, let's be honest. But it's really nice to be in a car with this kind of power and tactile sensation and actually have to shift for yourself. Makes it a whole lot more involving. It isn't faster, but it feels faster.
Woo! I'm digging this thing. So my recommendation is, yes, the 335 is a great car, but not for this price, not brand new. I think you should wait for at least 2 years and then find yourself one. You will not be sorry.
What's great about the IS is that they've actually tuned it into the car that I wish all the 3 Series were like. This is a car that makes you understand why BMW has the reputation that it does.
This is tough.
That is an amazingly close 3 cars.
It's really close.